90.3 KEXP, that was David Bowie's Rebel Rebel. Yet another artist who passed this year. So many, so sad. But we move on, and we have a living artist right here.
So to speak.
You are well? You're healthy?
Far as I can determine.
Good.
At this juncture.
Good. Don't let anything happen. Mike Doty is here live on the morning show. We welcome you back. Thanks for coming to KEXP, and we'd love to hear, I believe, playing some new songs.
Yes, I am. Yep.
Awesome. Take it away.
Cool. This appropriately for the week is called Wait, You'll Find a Better Way. I was a man alone, leaning on the white courtesy phone. Holy fools and hobo signs, I rebuke your moony lies. I drove into the sun, yeah, I was the dirt when the wheel spun. Wanting to escape myself, leave the gun upon the shelf. Stroll through, excuse me, but I thought I knew you. Smiling like a check is due, feeling pleasure that you're bound to lose. Or you'll find a better way. Or you'll find a better way. Or you'll find a better way. Wait. Or you'll find a better way. Or you'll find a better way. Or you'll find a better way. You were a holy mess. You were dressed in infinite forgiveness, but you were the heaviest cat in the crowd nonetheless. You were a wretched wave, all the sullen trolls that you swam out to save, all the moves and all your might, dust swirls and the sunlight. All things empty and amazing, jot them down upon the wall, dressed like a professional. Wait, or you'll find a better way. Or you'll find a better way. Or you'll find a better way. Wait, or you'll find a better way. Find a better way. Oh, you find a better way. I'm free to face all the darkness on my own. Free to face the darkness on my own. Oh yeah, I'm free to face all the darkness on my own. Free to face the darkness on my own. I'm free to face all the darkness on my own. Free to face the darkness on my own. Oh yeah, I'm free to face all the darkness on my own. I'm free to face the darkness on my own.
What a great line right now to hear.
Thank you. Well, thank you. Yes.
Wait, You'll Find a Better Way. And the album, The Heart Watches While the Brain Burns.
Correct.
I don't usually ask about album titles, but I got to ask about that one.
It's from a Marc Maron rant.
Yeah?
Yeah, something that he said. If you listen to his podcast, he spends the first 15 minutes essentially talking to himself in his garage. And it's something he said before he interviewed Richard Linklater. And he was talking about trying to quit nicotine gum. Not even trying to quit smoking, but trying to quit nicotine gum. Yeah. Yes. Recurring theme on his show is the gum. And he said, the brain burns while the heart sits there watching sadly. And I just said it into my little Sony voice recorder. I knew it was a title. I've known that guy for a billion years. I used to go see him on Ludlow Street in Lower East Side in the 90s. And I wrote him, and he was like, no memory of saying that. So there's one wonderful piece of poetry that I legitimately could have taken credit for.
The one time you asked permission.
The one time I asked permission. The one sample I seek clearance for.
He never would have known.
You know.
So you were out touring. It is a record store radio station tour. Records, well, this is half of that right station. Here. You've done it.
Exactly. And then Silver Platters later in the afternoon. And then I'm coming back with a band in February. February, yeah. Mm-hmm. The Crocodile.
Yep.
The show is going to be really, really good. And I come through every time and say it's going to be really, really good.
Yeah.
But I sort of devised this system for remixing the band live.
Yeah.
You see sort of hand signals that are like half James Brown, half John Zorn, that you sort of lower volume, get people to stop and start. And it really is like remixing a band live. Yeah. And it's a big band. There's another guitar player and keyboard player, bass and drums, and a backup vocalist. And I'm really excited for this.
What kind of rehearsals? How much do you have to practice for something like, or is it better not to overdo it before you?
Not that much. I like to keep them a little bit afraid. I like to sort of show them the chords. I think the Bob Dylan system of rehearsing people is fantastic, where people are like, "Whoa, what's he doing? What's he doing?" So as long as they know the signals,
right,
and they can improvise within the signals, and they know what the keys are, you can do anything, and it feels like you're composing on stage, and everybody, everyone's like cackling with mad laughter while this is happening.
Well, I can't speak for everyone, but that kind of show is what I love.
Yeah.
I don't want to see the same show and the same set list.
Yeah.
And the same, to see.
Well, it's not like jazzy. It's not jamming. It really is like songs.
Right.
And it's like the way a hip hop producer sort of balances stuff. Takes something in, takes something out, puts something back in, turns something up, turns something down.
And that's going to be in February, February 7th to be exact, at the Crocodile. But you will be playing Silver Platters later. We don't get ahead of ourselves.
Yes,
Silver Platters
let us
today.
Not.
Where were you yesterday?
I was in Portland.
How'd that go?
It went great. Music Millennium, fantastic store.
Great
Kink,
store.
Great station.
Yeah.
This has been really good. Here's the other thing is this record's really good. Again, like you go through, every city a million times and, shilling your wares, but I gotta say this one's really good. Every time I make a record, it comes out and I hear it in record stores when they play it before and after my little in-store appearance.
Yeah.
And I'm always like, man, I should have cut that song, or that goes on too long. And every time I hear this one, I'm like, this is what I meant.
I was gonna say, if you didn't believe that, you would say it. I have no doubt. Be like, it was all right this time.
It's true. This one's really good.
Yeah.
And it's weird because it's my ninth album. So
ninth solo album or ninth?
Ninth solo album,
wow.
12th including the Soul Coughing albums. Yeah.
Wow.
At this point, for the hardcore fan base, it's like homework.
Yeah.
So to really go out there, I mean, that's why I'm doing this tour as opposed to just doing the normal thing where I go out and I play the shows and then do a thing or two at a radio station during the day. It's like, no, wait, seriously. Listen to this one. Seriously.
Well, again, the album is called The Heart Watches While the Brain Burns, and I can back that up. I think it's one of your best. And you got another one for us today, and I think kind of fits here in Seattle, especially today.
It's
been,
yeah.
Even for Seattle, it's a little wet today.
This is called Sad Girl Walking in the Rain. Sad girl walking in the rain. Sad girl walking in the rain. Wide brown eyes seek the sunlight. Dry in the morning rise. She's gone. Wander all the night long. Shudder like the stars song. Sad girl walking in the rain. Sad girl walking in the rain. Swung low, she rode its own road. sighing like a noble. She roams, sleeping like a hobo, flying like a lost crow. Sad girl, walking in the rain. Sad girl, walking in the rain. Walking in the rain. Walking in the rain.
Mike Doty live here on The Morning Show. Sad Girl Walking in the Rain, new album again, As the Heart Watches While the Brain Burns. And you have another one here. Not from the new one?
Not from the new one. This is a soul carving song I rearranged for this little sort of Atari-looking device. Could stay here under your idle caress and not exit to the world and phoniness and people.
Mike Doty live here on The Morning Show. Love that.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's cool. Do you have songs in mind from your past that you think, oh, I want to change that? Or do you have to go back physically and listen and find those songs?
Well, that this thing, which is a Critter and Guitari pocket piano, I was touring with Low.
Yeah.
And Al from Low spends way too much money on gear. Yeah. So he comes home from like every sound check, he goes out and buys something expensive and comes back to sound check and messes around with it. And this is a thing that he bought. And I just loved it. And I was like, I got to figure out something to do with it.
Okay, sure.
And because the guitar pattern on Lazy Bones is do-da, 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 like that, and that was easy to replicate on this thing, the arrangement of it gradually grew out, you know, because the arpeggios can get sort of broader and faster and slower. And so it came out of the instrument more than anything else.
Well, you have that and you have your guitar. Are you a gear guy, or is this is most we're going to see from you? Are you now, you know, has that changed over the years?
In terms of, well, yeah, I mean, I tour in a bunch of different formats. I would be touring with my cello player, Andrew Scrap Livingston, but he had some health problems, had to stay home, which is a drag, but he's getting better. He had surgery. He's at home twiddling his thumbs, playing his cello. he's going to be coming out as my bass player as well as cello player in February. So
yeah, so you have more instruments with you, especially in February. And so did you move?
Yes, more where it's warmer. Where the band can huddle together on stage.
Yeah, exactly. And speaking of warmer, you've moved, right? You left New York?
I went to Memphis, Tennessee. Yeah.
How long did you live in New York?
26 years.
Wow. Yeah. And you moved to Memphis when?
Long time. About almost 2 years ago.
And you're clearly happy. You're still there.
Very happy. Yeah. It's a great city. I was going to move to Nashville. And there's no, you know, much love for Nashville, but Memphis is like better than Nashville. Memphis is like, it's like, it's kind of like Austin was in the late 80s.
Okay.
It's really kind of, it's like kind of spooky. It's got a vibe to it. There's like a darkness and a grittiness to it. And the word authenticity is problematic. But there's a tremendous amount of authenticity to Memphis.
What do you? I mean, anyone who leaves New York, there's things you can't replicate. Are there things you're bumming about or you're missing?
Just my friends. Yeah. I mean, other than that, you know, like honestly, if it wasn't for Facebook, it'd be harder. But now I feel like I'm completely in the swing of all my New York friends' life, and they're all leaving New York anyway. So we're all getting into long distance relationships as it is.
So you're out on the road, you're playing the record store and radio station tour, you're seeing these record stores, you're going to these radio stations, Silver Platters later today at 7 p.m., and while you play those, the election happens, and people are looking to artists. What do you see as the role of the artist when people are hurting or when something they don't agree with has happened?
I have made some songs before that have a very particular political point of view, and I'm proud of them as songs, but periodically I learn the hard way that not everybody agrees with what I agree with, and sometimes they have a point. Not always, and sometimes it's just like a little bit of a point. So I mean, I don't know if my politics are transparent. I suspect they are. But I was very, very upset, preventing myself from yelling. I was in a hotel room with my friend Liam. We were yelling, just tremendously upset. But, you know, the next day, you know, you gotta figure out what everybody else is, what's on their mind and what they want. And I mean, you know, I think this is a time for tremendous vigilance. But we must keep in mind that other people think differently, and just because we think we're smarter, which is in itself not a liberal value, to think you're smarter than everybody else and know everything. If you're not questioning yourself, you're not a liberal. You gotta try. I mean, it's really difficult. You gotta try.
I couldn't agree more. And you're, you know, and people are out there, I was almost unfair to the art. You know, they're looking for somebody to speak for them too.
Yeah.
When they're at shows, it doesn't matter what's going on. You know, it doesn't have to be political. But when there's things going on, you look up, and as an artist, even playing songs on the radio show, you think you're being inauthentic if you are just playing party jams.
Yeah.
When a lot of people are writing you and saying they're sad or they're... So you have to balance those things, I suppose, when you're up there live. I don't envy the artist who stands in front of an audience and does that.
Yeah, and it's a peculiar time because I think the political figure in question is not authentic in his beliefs. And I think that it could have just as easily been, Ted Cruz and Donald Trump going, we're going to have free college. We're going to have great free college. We're going to have the best free college. It's going to be the best. We're going to have the best getting rid of your credit card debt. We're going to have the best minimum wage. It's a template. So if it was Donald Trump versus Ted Cruz, would I be going, Donald, he's not so bad. Again, not a huge fan of the guy. I'm getting way more political than I told myself I would, but I can't help it. Here's the thing is kind of a stock Twitter insult is you mad. Letter U space MAD for the older people,
sure.
Such as myself. Sure. You mad, which is like if somebody gets upset about something, you just write you mad, and it's an insult. You mad should no longer be an insult. We should want to be mad. We should want to be angry.
Mike Doty, you can see him later at 7 p.m. Silver Platters. See my segue to your live show.
The ranting will not happen at Silver Platters.
No. The Heart Watches While the Brain Burns is the name of the album. And you know what? No matter how you're feeling, we here so believe in the power of music to get you through whatever it is, good or bad.
Agreed.
And a lot of songs speak for you. And that voice that you may not be able to find. And Mike, you've done a great job of it over the years. I've found a lot of your songs to be that way. We got one more, and this is the one we played. I think we debuted or came close to debuting. We played it really early on the
show.
Yes,
it's a great song.
And it's from the new album as well. And again, coming back in February, do stay tuned. We're going to be giving away tickets to that show. I'm not going to forget coming up in February because we're presenting that show. One more from Mike Doty.
This is called I Can't Believe I Found You in That Town from The Heart Watches While the Brain Burns. Oh, my days, they were so easy till I kissed you in that door. Now my arms feel so empty like they never did before. And I can't believe I found you in that town. I can't believe it's true, I can't believe just how I'm missing you. You do not call, you never make a sound. No, at least not like you made when I was close to you, so sweet and so profound. And I can't believe I found you in that town. I don't want to feel this insane. I don't want to call you, but my hands can't stop remembering the way you're smooth. And I can't believe I found you in that town. I can't cease to see your face, and I can still smell all the traces of a feeling I don't want to come around. Let it leave me like a long breath that didn't dissipate or fade in the background. And I can't believe I found you in that town. I can't believe I found you in that town. I can't believe I found you in that town. Well, I can't believe I found you in that. Can't believe I found you in that town. And I can't believe I found you in that town. I can't believe it's true, I can't believe this how I'm missing you. You do not call, you never make a sound. No, at least not like you made when I was close to you, so sweet and so profound. And I can't believe I found you in that town. Well, I can't believe I found you in that sound. All my days, they were so easy till I kissed you in that door. Now my arms, they feel so empty, like they never did before.
Mike Doty here on The Morning Show. I can't believe I found you in that town. And that's got to be on my scale of green guitars, my favorite.
Oh,
in the studio.
Thanks.
I don't know how many green guitars have been in here, but that's a pretty guitar.
It was complimented by David Letterman, one of the finest moments of my life. He came out during the like clap and handshake part, and he said, "That's a beautiful guitar."
That's what they say when they come out and shake your hand.
And I said, "You're a great American poet." And he went, "Way." So I totally ruined the moment by fanboying on him.
I love that. Later today, Silver Platters, 7 p.m., and then you are off to Boise, Idaho.
Off to Boise and
beautiful Boise.
Boise. They get.
You're right. I was born in Idaho. I should know.
Yeah. They get finicky about it, and God bless them.
It's going to be a record exchange, and you're seeing some good record stores too. That's so important to your community.
Yes.
And these kind of things going to in studios or in stores, I should say, and buying an artist's music, a good way to help everybody.
Absolutely. I mean, vinyl. Vinyl is a gift to us. I mean, not only in terms of something that people actually go out and buy, but it is so great. Buying vinyl is so much fun.
Yeah, and my 12-year-old held up a record he bought, and he said, "Dad, all the words to the songs are on here. Did you know that?"
I'm like, "Oh, yes.
This is a good day." And I've decided that through him is how I'm going to help. Because, you know, I get music here all the time. So I don't, and I'm sitting here bitching at everyone to pay for it. And I'm like, I don't.
Right.
And so I'm doing my part.
Yeah.
So I'm doing it through him. Just getting as much vinyl as we can into his brain. And
In
stores are a great way for next generations as well to get record stores and see artists. And hey, if you, when you come back in February, if there's any way you can work this place into your schedule, I'd love to see. I don't know, when you're doing that live with a band, is that something you can do in a session like?
Sure, absolutely.
I don't want to put you on the hook to do that. Scheduling is hard, but you're welcome.
I mean, if we can swing it, I'd love to do it, particularly like if you shoot it on the video cameras.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. They're right here. Yeah. They're locked in as
well. But at the very least, like, please, you know, I've been telling everybody I know, like sort of friends and music business people, like, actually come to this one. Like, I invite
never mind the others.
I mean, like,
this is the one.
I'm serious. This is very Boy That Cried Wolf. This is a wolf. This is an actual wolf.
It's February 7th. And by the way, we're presenting that show, and it's in February. I don't know what you're doing on Tuesday, February 7th, but if you text Mike to 206-903-5397, Mike is in the name, not what I'm talking on, to 206-903-5397. We'll get a bunch of you into that show again. 206-903-5397. Text Mike's name.
Also, I'm sure you can find my phone number somewhere on the internet. And if you do and text me, I'll put you on the list.
Wow, if you can track down Mike Doty's phone number on the internet.
There's gotta be somebody on 4chan that can get my number. And free tickets to Trolls.
Oh, wow. That's a new contest.
There you go.
If we had the number, that would be really bad.
That would be really bad.
Your phone would be going off in the studio, which would be great for me, but bad for you. Mike, thanks again. It's always good to see you.
It is fantastic to be here.
And congrats on the new record. Again, I recommend it as well. And I recommend the show in February, and we hope to see you again in our studios. And a big thank you to everybody who listens to and supports the station and allows artists to be heard live. We are KEXP Seattle. All right.
Always such a pleasure.
That was great.
Always such a pleasure. Yeah, I have told every DJ this week.
Discover new music at listener-powered KEXP.org.